If you are wondering what and how to teach your 2.5 to 3 years old, this video is right for you. You should watch till the end. Hi guys, my name is Pragya. I have done this video in the past. If you want to check out, I'll put the link in the description box. It is all about how and what to teach your 2 years old. So if you're looking for that kind of content, you should watch that first, because my daughter is turning 3 tomorrow. This video is definitely for 2.5 to 3 years old. But if you're wondering what to teach your 2 years old, definitely check out that video. I teach my daughter 3 to 4 days in a week, that's it, and only 30 to 35 minutes every time. She does like to sit down and study for at least 30 minutes. It does not happen throughout the year. Definitely she likes to take breaks, and mostly in the fall season she is not much into studies, but it's okay. Whenever she is interested, I teach her. So this is how her syllabus looks like now. I have divided her syllabus into 8 sections. So first we start off with the coloring, so that she's all happy and into the mood. And when we are doing coloring, we also like to talk about things, and like, what's your favorite color, what's your favorite fruit, and what color is the banana, what color is the strawberry, and any kind of small talks on the favorite things.
And what is your name?
I am
your name is Nirvi?
I special.
You're 3 years old already? Awesome! High five!
So these kind of books you can buy from Dollarama or Toys R Us or anywhere, you know. You can find anywhere these kind of books. I think it's good to give them pencil color instead of crayons or the pen to color, because it's very much easy for them to grip, and also trace the color and trace the lines. Pens and the watercolors, they slip a lot, so it's good for them to have that grip and hold on the pencil. So once they are good in holding the pencil, because first they'll hold like from the top, and then like this, and then like this, and then like this. So there will be so many stages of them for holding the pencil also. So I encourage you to do this activity first before teaching them how to write. After doing the coloring, we call it as a black book thing. So it is actually a black folder, and this is just a folder with some transparent pages. So I have added 11 sheets which I got printed, and first is like the days in a week, months of a year, then weather and shapes and vegetables, fruits, jungle animals, body parts, and rainbow, and other things. So there are not 11, there are 13 sheets, and she loves to read this book. She goes very patiently with all the pages.
Okay, how many days in a week, Nirvi?
7.
Okay.
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Good job. And how many months in a year, Nirvi? How many months in a year?
12.
Awesome. Can you name them?
January, February,
March,
April.
So I encourage you to use, silly pictures when you are teaching your kids. Otherwise, they get very bored. Soon I'll be changing all the pages. After maybe a week, I'll change all the pages of this folder and I'll teach something else. So if you want to check out what I'm gonna do, you can follow me on Instagram. I post a lot about the homeschooling thing and also motherhood and behind the scene everything. So you can find so many helpful tips over there. You can follow me on Instagram, it's free. And I also like to check out DMs and chat with you all. So let's get into the third point, is tracing. Yes, now she is almost 3. It's important for her to trace few things. So sometimes I allow her to trace in this book, which is actually for 3+ kids, but we introduced her a little bit sooner, and I don't know if it is the right decision or not, but there are some numbers and letters and the patterns which she can trace. Now, because in this book they require a marker, I do not prefer this book much. Rather than that, I prefer a blank page, and I just give her little exercise, like I give her standing line dashes, and then she has to trace, then slipping line, then curves, then C, then U and V and A. So I give her dashes and she has to complete that. This is the basic way, and I think is the best way also to teach them how to trace and how to write. You can expect so many random things from them, out of them, because they are not used to hold, and their bones have not developed completely of their palm, so they'll hold weirdly and trace weirdly. Just keep patience, they'll get there. Number fourth is the chart. We have two charts. One is the number chart, and one is of Hindi alphabets. So if you are doing any language, we definitely have to start with the basic and the alphabets. So I encourage you to buy a chart, or you can also do the flashcards for that. So initially we used to do flashcard, but that didn't work out well with her in the second language, which is Hindi for her, not for us. So yeah, we got that from India, and we just go through it. We play a teacher game. So it's also a nice way to allow them to teach you. So she goes very random, and she's very funny when she's teaching me. And then I take my turn and I ask her to sit down and listen to me, and then I teach her the alphabets.
She eat. Go, 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 ear. No, 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 ear. Cha, 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 ear. No, 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 ear. Pa, 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 ear.
A, A, E, E, U, U. Rishi A, A, O, O, Ah.
Same goes with the number thing. I'm teaching her from 1 to 50. Initially, you should start with 1 to 10. And after doing 1 to 10, when they are very much comfortable in telling all the numbers 1 to 10, then you can go from 20 to 30 and 30 to 40. So what I'm doing is 1 to 50. And then I go on the bottom line, like 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So that's what is my goal. I want to make her learn that much first, and then we'll go further.
34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Good job. Number 6 is reading. It's very important to read aloud with your kids. Then they pick a lot of vocab words. Next is also they learn more about the season and the festival which is going on. So I encourage you to read at least 5 books. You should start with 1 word or 2 words in a book. So what we are doing a combination, because I want to teach her the opposites, and also about the weather and the festival, whatever is going on that month, and also some basic other stuff. And then there is 1, 2, 3, because I want to teach her 1, 2, 5. By seeing the object, she should be able to tell me how many they are, just from 1 to 5. This is the thing that they should know before turning 5. If you want to enroll them into the kindergarten, this is the thing here. So yes, I'm teaching her, and then she can trace over here like this, 3 and 9. So you know, she can trace, and she can tell me how many are there.
It's a dolphin.
How many are there?
1, 2, 3.
3 dolphins. Yes, you're right.
Moving towards point number 7, which is again my favorite, is circle time. So we start with roly poly.
Roly poly, roly roly, up, 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 up. Roly roly poly, roly roly poly, down, down, down. Down, down, down. Roly, roly, roly poly. Out, out, out. Out, out, out. Roly, roly poly. Roly, roly poly. In, in, in. in. Rolly, rolly, rolly ball. Loud, loud, loud. Loud, loud, loud. Rolly, rolly, polly. Rolly, rolly, polly. Good job.
Hello.
Okay. Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? How are you today?
Then we move towards the hello song. Hello, how are you? My name is Pragyan. I'm 27 years old. What's your name? So I'm teaching her. Her name is Nervi. Papa's name is Nimish. How old are you? How old is Papa? How old is your mama? So this is how I'm teaching her. Then we move towards weather. I always ask her whenever she gets up, how is the weather outside? And whenever we are studying, how is the weather outside? And from that we move towards some rhyme section in which they can go from 5 to 1.
Ready? Five little monkeys sitting on a tree, teasing Mr. Crocodile, you can't catch me. One comes down and touches the crocodile and... How many left?
Four.
Four little monkeys sitting on a tree, teasing Mr. Crocodile, you can't catch me. One comes down and see crocodile and... How many left?
Three.
So five little monkeys sitting on a tree, and five little monkeys jumping on the bed. Five little ducks went out one day. So anything which goes from 5 to 1. And then we move towards head, shoulder, knees and toes, and row, row, row your boat. So there are so many which we practice, and it totally depends on our mood.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. If you see a crocodile, don't forget to scream.
And last thing, eighth thing is a goodbye song. Any goodbye song sets their mood, like school time is over now. Otherwise they just go crazy, you know, they just want to study and sing rhymes, and it's really frustrating. So at least this is the case with me. So hello song and the goodbye song are very important. I'm not gonna be homeschooling for the rest of my life, so I'll try my level best to keep it simple. So this is what I teach and how I teach Nervi at home. I really hope that you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to check out more such videos, that how to entertain your kids at home full day, and how to teach your 2 years old at home. I keep things very simple and enjoyable. It surely will send her to school because she loves to be in school. I've seen her enjoying in the school when she goes to a strong start, and the free program which runs, which happens over here in our state particularly. I don't know about other state, but there is a free program which happens over here. I take her 3 days over there, and it is a preschool program. It's free, and I think it's a very good start to see your kids enjoy, and it's very good thing to see your kids develop and being around with the friends. And she really loves to hang out with her friends, so I do not want to take that opportunity back from exposing her to kids. But definitely I have a checklist before sending her to preschool, so I'm not sending her till she's 4 and a half, no matter what. So this is how I teach. If you are interested in more such videos, do let me know in the comment section. Soon I'm gonna be changing the syllabus a little bit, so if you're interested in seeing the updated one when she's already 3, let me know in the comment section. I'll do that for you. If you enjoyed, make sure to like this video. Do not forget to share it with other mamas, please, please, please. And again, follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I'll see you guys in my next one. And please don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.